Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to use a text generation model locally. In my last video, I talked about using a diffusion model to generate images. For this tutorial, I'll be using Google Colab because I know many of us don't have a powerful PC or laptop. First, go to Google, search for Google Colab and click on the official link. Once it loads, you will see an interface like this. On the bottom left, click on New Notebook. In the New Notebook, we'll start by naming it. You can name it whatever you like. In my case, I am naming it Text Generation. Next, go to the Runtime menu and click on Change Runtime Type. A pop-up will appear and instead of CPU, which is selected by default, choose T4 GPU and click Save. Since we'll be using a model with billions of parameters, a CPU won't be sufficient and a GPU will provide faster responses. At the top right corner, you'll see a Connect button. Click on it to connect the notebook to the GPU. Once the GPU is connected, you'll see the system specs such as 12.7GB of system RAM, 15GB of GPU RAM and 112GB of disk storage. While these specs might seem sufficient, trust me, they aren't enough to run models with 7 billion parameters. In this video, I'll be using a model called TinyLlama, which is trained on 3 trillion tokens and has 1.1 billion parameters. My main goal is to show you how to use a Hugging Face open source model locally. This approach will enable you to use any model as long as your system can handle it. I've already written the code and I'll run the cells one by one to explain what each part of the code does. First, this code checks which hardware device is available for running PyTorch operations. It first checks if a CUDA compatible GPU is available and returns CUDA if true. If not, it checks if the Metal Performance Shaders MPS backend is available, which is used on Macs with M1 or M2 chips, and returns MPS if true. If neither is available, it defaults to CPU. The getDevice function determines the appropriate device, assigns it to the device variable, and prints the selected device type. Next, we import pipeline from the Transformers library, which by default uses models like GPT-2 or other pre-trained models depending on the task. Here we set up a sentiment analysis pipeline and specify the device to run it on based on the earlier device configuration. The classifier analyzes the text. I've been waiting for a Hugging Face course my whole life and determines whether the sentiment is positive, negative or neutral along with its confident score. Next we create a text generation pipeline using transformers and specify the model TinyLlama V1.0. The pipeline uses torch.bfloat16 for efficient computation and runs on the previously determined device. A function generate text is defined, which takes user at input as a parameter and generates text using the generator. It allows up to 256 new tokens and uses sampling parameters like temperature equals 0.7, top k equals 50, and top p equals 0.95 for more varied outputs. The generated text is then printed alongside the user's input. At the end, the script prompts the user for input, calls generate text with the provided prompt, and displays the chatbot's response. If you are running it for the first time, you will need to wait a bit for the installation. After that, you can ask this TinyLlama model any question you want. However, don't expect great answers every time because this is a base model trained on limited data and with fewer parameters. My goal here is to show you how to use open source models locally, and this is a perfect example. If you enjoyed this breakdown, don't forget to subscribe, as I'll be sharing many more AI tutorials soon.